good morning to everybody. I am Varatharaj, and I have a 12-year experience in full R&D, design and development. And I am working at Avtech Limited, where it is placed at Hosur. I just came here for to present the vibration, some information I wanted to share to you on design optimization of the gearbox for vibration noise. Basically, Avtech Limited is indigenous in the transmission product design, as well as in the precision manufacturing in India, and we have a plant in a global in Switzerland also. We have four branches in India. R&D is centralized in Hosur, and then other two plants are Chennai and as well as in Pithampur. We have under big CK Block Group company, and 20,000 employees are there overall, and USD of about $2 billion of a turnover. And actually, what we are doing is a heavy product engineering, like off-highway transmission as well as automotive transmission, and plus automotive engines we manufacture and selling to the OEMs, like all the automotive OEM as well as earth mover, plus defense equipment also. And these are the locations where we have placed in India as well as global. And these are our global product segment, where you can find out off-highway transmissions and one side, and then this is automotive engine and transmissions. And we also do the contract manufacturing of gears and shafts. And we have owned our face gear technology, we have patented. And the background of this paper is, again, our people are looking for the comfort in everywhere, where actually whenever you sit here also, as well as on the traveling time. So in all the passenger car, as well as in the automotive transmission or automotive vehicles, or even take the rail or take the aerospace, the comfort is a key points where we need to look into that. And particularly with respect to the comfort, NVH is a very important and then key role. And here, the NVH contribution is a very important factor for the comfort. The human ears is detecting the pure tone from the NVH aspect. The objective, again, I am coming to this, to minimize the noise, vibration or hardness in the gearbox through the appropriate analysis background. This was the targets and then given from the customers in the vehicle. These are the three conditions. The dB level should be 98 dB and then 93, 102, like that, in the various situation like vehicle transportations. And these are the duty cycle where we need to test the noise for the gearbox from the speed of 100 to, you can find out the 330 km per speed to 100 km per hour speed. Where the different load cases, these are the torque load. With that, what are the dB levels, I mean noise level for the gearbox for the each conditions to the gearbox transmissions. Basically, when you talk about the gearbox, there are some critical sources are there to create the noises. One thing is the gears. When the gears mesh happening, there is a noise. When there is a shaft, during the rotation, wind noise, there are many multiple noises are there during the shaft rotation. And even the bearings also cause a noise. And third one is the load variation. During the load variation of the torque variation as well as speed variation, the dB level, nothing but the noise may increase or decrease. And then housing, all these factors is a source, nothing but is inducing the noise, and then absorbing the noise by housings and then emitting outside. These are the detailed sources of the noise, where you can find the disturbance in the gearbox, gear mesh disturbance when you talk about impact of the gears and sliding and rolling based on the gear impact, the noise will create. And also oil ejection, load variations, and then because of this, tooth stiffness variations are happening in the gear mesh, so the noises are happening. And then disturbance energy transportation, how the disturbance are getting transferred to the gearbox through the bearing disturbance, and then it goes to the housing through all the medium of shaft, bearings, and then housings. Then from the housing, the acoustic energy is coming out from the transmission housing, nothing but a gearbox housing, So that we are hearing as a noise, where it is coming unwanted vibration and noise. This is a little more detail about the gear noise as a whole gearbox transmission noise. From the angle of gear to the noise, it is just a thermal, you can find out the first box, there is a thermal distortion and then pinion movement, tooth deflection, all those. If you are expert on the gear design or gear background, then all those parameters will be familiar. But at present, I just explain the pinion. There are the two gear measures, for example, pinion and then wheel. There is a backlash, there is a profile, there is a back face wheel, there is a. So due to that, there is a pitch variations are happening. So that is called a transmission error. Through the transmission error, the transmission is nothing but the variation of the stiffness in the gear mesh frequency. So that is going to the bearing forces, and it's nothing but the gear. From the gear, the excitation going to the shaft, and then from the shaft, the excitation going to the bearing. And then bearing also adding the multiplication of the vibration, then again it is transferring the gearbox. So the gearbox noise is getting outside, and then that is called as a dB, vibration here, vibration and noise. This is what the approach we are following for the noise and vibration, minimizing the noise and vibration in the gearbox. Initially, we take the gear and shaft bearing, and then duty cycle, and the 3D model of the housing, as well as the internal gearbox model, gearbox components. And there are the two approaches there, internal component optimization, and then housing optimization, nothing but rotational component optimization, and then stationary component optimization. Here, rotational component optimization, the focus was the transmission error reductions, as well as the contact pattern reduction optimization. So that gives the acceleration to the housing and housings. Nothing but here also we do the housing dynamic model analysis. We are also finding out the critical mode shapes. And then again, both together, we do the total vibration and noise analysis. From that, we are finalizing the gearbox design. So there are two optimization lines. One is the modification of the housings, and one more is optimization of the macro gear geometry. This is our gearbox. You can find out the two gear pair, and this is the two-stage gearbox where it is going on the vehicle. So from that, we use a customized software, the Romax as well as the Nastran FEM. And then this is the transmission error. You can find out the design equipment, like a blue color you can find 2.79, and this orange color 2.21 is nothing but the input pair gear pair and output gear pair transmission error variations. Again, it is all the levels are above the 2 microns. The vertical value is a 2 micron transmission error. And then we have tested it clockwise, anti-clockwise with respect to various duty cycle conditions. And then we also done the contact pattern, where you can find out the contact pattern where on the gear flank. So it has to be uniform distributor load. And this is the initial design analysis. The current situation, how it is behaving, we are studying. So you can find out the variable load contact pattern, which is not good in the design. At various low torque to higher torque, maximum torque is 2,700 Newton meter. So now, once we do the transmission error and then contact pattern, we can able to understand what is this, and then how it is influencing to the vibrations. So as I told you in the initially, the transmission error is exerting the load to the housings. So that we have seen. And then next we are seeing the vibrations. So we are doing the sweeping of from 0 to 2500 hertz with a speed of 0 to 3824 RPM. And we wanted to measure at a particular area where the customers are very interested, as well as our experience also on the cantilever areas, the excitation of the vibration will be more. And then we are all measuring the XY, the three direction of vibrations. This is the first input gear pair and then output gear pair acceleration versus speed. And we are also finding with the Campbell diagram where which order and which acceleration mesh frequency is happening. And then last one is the mode shape analysis, where the housings have a more mass participation is happening. So based on the acceleration of the component, which area is getting more deflection, due to that what is the mass participation? So where it is getting more deflections, so that area we need to give that good stiffness to arrest the housing deflections, so that whatever the inside induced housings noises are coming inside, so that will not come out. So it will be isolated in the gearbox itself. So you can find out the gearbox. That is a first number. First one is a most mode number, and then with respect to the frequency, gearbox. The gearbox having a mass participation of around 58 to some level. Minimum level is that is acceptable. And more than that, we need to attack. More than that, we need to optimize the housing. It can go mass, more mass also, less mass also, based on the stiffness calculations of the housing. These are the frequency mode, I mean critical mode shapes. It starts from the 800 to 2200 like that. We can take number of n number of mode shapes, but what are the band, frequency band, with respect to that, we can able to get it. So basically, that is a rule to attack the optimization level on the critical mode shapes. So you can find out the hotspot of the mode shapes, wherever the slimmy, wherever the thickness is less, there vibration getting more. I mean, that mode shape is getting, so there we need to attack. And this is one example for the higher torque load condition with a 2,700 Nm with a speed of sweep of 0 to 3,824 RPM with the counterclockwise. Again, the compile diagram we predicted, and then we also understood the input and output gearbox acceleration value, where it is this is the initial design. We have found it is more than 61 acceleration value. And with respect to the counterclockwise, these are the mode shapes. You will find out more than 51 also there, 51 mass participation percentage. That means kinetic energy participations. We have done, we have 8 to 12 load cases are there. I just put here for the only one load cases, where otherwise it will go 2.5 hours. Here, the dB level of this 2,700 Nm, 93 dB is coming here, with respect to the torque level of 2,700. And now we are going to the gearbox optimization. So these are the analysis data, where it is initially done with an design analysis. Nothing but the designed component, normally designed component. These are the analysis data. Based on that, we need to going to optimize the gearbox. So focus, we are focusing on the optimization. There are some parameters we are taking. Microgeometry aspect, we are taking the lead crowning and then tip relief. Lead crowning, nothing but the where there is a tooth. On the over that, we are going to like paralleling, nothing but the radius on the both side. Simply, there is no picture to explain it. And then tip relief, nothing but the end relief, nothing but when the gear is rotating, it has to get the relief. So nothing but when you design the shaft, it will be for providing the entry chamber kind of thing. So that is a logic here, we are giving the tip relief, but it has a linear, and then parabolic, there are many types. And then also we are focusing macro geometries, pressure angle, helix angle, phase width, module. By changing all these parameters, how the behavior is getting affected. How the vibration transmitter is getting affected. So basically, by changing this, how the transmitter is getting affected, you can now see with respect to the various concepts, nothing but you can find out the nominal design, initial one, this is the lengthier one, higher one. And then you can find out the variable, with respect to the variable concept, we will find out the transmission reductions. So we are selecting the micro geometry plus helix angle modification as a combination. Here we are seeing the very good, as a best combinations that we are taking from the 2.79 to 1.19 range we are bringing down. This is the overall concept. And then this is for the input and output transmission error, where it is giving at least, 30 to 50% of the variations, optimization values we are bringing down. And this is the profile contact ratio, where it is related to the contact ratio. And earlier one is the transmission error, where it is related to the backlash and then the micro geometry. And this is the contact ratio, where it is also interacting with the durability. Actually, we done the optimization keeping that durability as a constant, because noise NVH, when you want to optimize the NVH, durability also may be missed out. So it is actually inversely proportional. When you see about the NVH, then you will miss the durability. When you want to optimize the durability, you will miss out the NVH on the gearbox. So there is a trade-off is required. So for both, we need to understand this contact ratio. We also calculated the profile contact ratio, and you will see the conjugate topology, how it is getting impact on the gear mesh. So you will find out the flat area where it is maximum area is getting conducted. Also, it is optimal. If it is more, then noise will be more. If it is less, then durability will be less. So there are more controversy. And then here you can find out the nominal and optimal design. This is the macro geometry, and this is the macro geometry table. So this is the finally micro geometry input gear. What we have done, the nominal design and optimized design. This is for the output gear pair. You can find out the less than one, less than one should not be there in the contact profile ratio. So we have kept more than one, which is very optimal for the, even for the lower torque. When it is having a higher torque level of the gear mesh, there will be a good stiffness so that you will not get more noise. But when you have a lower torque, you will get a free gear mesh so that you will get a rattle noise. There are different types of noises in the gearbox. Whine noise, rattle noise, and then moan noise. But we are attacking here whine noise, plus also additionally attacking the rattle noise due to the by doing the contact profile ratio on the lower torque areas. This is the finalizer input gear pair, output gear pair for the micro geometry. You can find out the nominal design to optimize design. Lead crowning, we have kept initially 20, and then in the optimized thing, 10 we have kept. Then we also study the manufacturing feasibility. The 10 micro, then 10 micrometers possible in the manufacturing which we have in the setup of on our company. Similarly for the output gear, actually I done a mistake, this is output gear pair. And here also we have modified. So you can find out the micro geometry. We have touched lead crown, slope, lead slope, and then parabolic tip relief, parabolic tip relief start, everything is coming into the picture. And then design optimization on the, right now we have seen about the gear geometry and we are going to the housing optimization model. So initially this was, initially there was two ribs are here, then we have added the ribs based on the kinetic energy, what is the mass participation factor. Based on that we have added the ribs, and then we have modified the covers stiffness also. It is nothing but increasing the stiffness according to the NVH requirement. And also we have improved kinetic energy. You can see in the top bottom, 13 to 50, from 54 to 13%, like that. From more than 40% wherever it is there, we have reduced. And this is what the acceleration values for the every gear mesh. I will quickly go through. And this is the vibration measurement with respect to the acceleration input shaft. And this is the load condition, the noise graph for the one load condition, 2700 Nm, where we are getting less than 100. So the specification was 102. And this is for the counterclockwise direction. And this is for the other load conditions, where other than 2700 Nm, all other load cases. And then finally, this was the conclusion, like we have optimized with respect to the micro geometry and then housing optimizations. And we also found out the vibration levels of XYZ directions. And we also found out the dB level, noise level, where it is all within the spec. Within the acceptable level, wherever the 102, instead of that 102, 93 we are getting. Similarly, XY is the main points which we need to take the, because Y direction is a vertical direction accelerations, where we have optimized the vibration level from the 61, XL 61G level from here 14.
So dynamic implicit, dynamic explicit, or is it a static structural calculation for that contact?
Basically start with the static analysis, then we'll end up with the dynamic analysis where we are finding out the acceleration and other things. It starts from the static analysis where we are finding out the transmission error, and then again it is dynamic transmission error, static transmission errors are there. Even you want to take about the contact pattern, it is a dynamic only, not a static. All these systems, why we are doing the as a system, we can do it with the gear mesh, as a gear mesh alone with the KISSoft or any other software. But why we are going for the ROMAX software is nothing but the whole system, we can do it with the dynamic conditions, where you can include the housing onto the rotating components like gearbox. If you want to test only on the housings or only on the gearbox, then it is not a system analysis.
Sir, you told that
input gear pair and then below one output gear pair. Okay, there are two gear pairs. Each gear pair we have done the micro geometries, and each micro geometry effect, that means transmission error contact pattern, we have given excitation to the housings. So it accelerates, So it gives a noise and vibrations effect.
And you told macro geometry optimization.
Ah, yes.
That your pressure angle you are changing from 20 to 10.
We have taken a parameter, but we have not changed the parameter. I mean on the optimizations, yes. We have done background of this, we have done lots of iterations.
Did you consider the manufacturing deviation also in the
calculus? Yes, while fixing the micro geometry analysis, we have set the parameter, no, I told you, micro geometry about 10 microns. That is set because of the manufacturing analysis, background of manufacturing feasibility only. Otherwise, I would have set 5 microns. Because 5 microns for my optimization, it is good result. Why I came for the 10 microns? Because of the manufacturing. We consider everything.
Did you validate the results? Or
yes, yes, we have validated. And now it is in the testing.
Okay.
So doing good.
Thank you, Varatharaj. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.